I 2 Timothy 1, 6-14. The Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but give us power, love, and self-discipline. 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. For today's episode, January 10, 2022, the title of our Bible reading for today is Here Be Dragons. Legend has it that at the edges of medieval maps, marking the boundaries of the world the map's creators knew at the time, there'd be inscribed the words, Here Be Dragons, often alongside vivid illustrations of the terrifying beasts supposedly lurking there. There is not much evidence medieval cartographers actually wrote these words, but I like to think they could have. Maybe because here be dragons sounds like something I might have written at the time. A grim warning that even if I didn't know exactly what would happen if I ventured into the great unknown, it likely wouldn't be good. But there's one glaring problem with my preferred policy of self-protection and risk aversion. It's the opposite of the courage to which I'm called as a believer in Jesus. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. One might even say I'm misguided about what's really dangerous. As Paul explained, in a broken world, bravely following Christ will sometimes be painful. Verse 8. But as those brought from death to life and entrusted with the Spirit's life flowing in and through us. Verses 9 to 10 and 14. How could we not, when God gives us a gift this staggering, to fearfully shrink back would be the real tragedy, far worse than anything we might face when we follow Christ's leading into uncharted territory. Verses 6 to 8 and 12. He can be trusted with our hearts and our future. Verse 12. By Monica LaRose. Is there a particularly debilitating fear God may be calling you to confront? How might the support of another believers encourage you? Loving God, thank you for the new life you've given us, for freedom from all that would cripple us in fear and shame. Help us to find peace in you. Thanks for watching.